Hello, everyone. My name is Chad Hart. I'm an extension economist at Iowa State University. And today I'd like to catch you up on what USDA released here in August, not only with the WASDE report, but we also got the crop production report, which contained not only the update on acreage from the Farm Service Agency, but also the first yield estimates coming from the farmer surveys. And both those had a very large impact as we're looking at the markets. And so without further ado, pull up my slide set here. And so as we're looking right now, the reports came out August 12th. The idea is what we saw within the updates were some tremendous changes in the numbers. For example, for corn, let me start with the supply side. For 2025, what USDA found as they looked at the Farm Service Agency acreage data, it showed even more corn than we thought was planted early on. They ended up increasing to 97.3 million acres of corn being planted, which is up over 2 million acres from our estimate last month. You combine that with a yield now weighing it at 188.8 bushels per acre, which is up nearly 8 bushels per acre from the previous estimate. Put that all together, and what you get is a billion more bushels being projected for this year's corn crop. And that is amazing considering we were already at a record 15.7 billion bushels being projected. Now we're at 16.7 billion bushels. So this is by far the largest crop we've ever seen, exceeding the previous record, which we set in 2023, by 1.4 billion bushels. So we got plenty of supply to work with. Now, when we look down at the gray box, the demand side of the marketplace, what we saw were a lot of positive changes. It's just that they dwarf in comparison to that production increase. Let me start with the 2024 column here, because we're just finishing up that marketing year now here in August. And what USDA found as they looked there was they made some minor adjustments here. They ended up reducing ethanol by about 30 million bushels there. So still a very strong year, but not quite the record usage year we were looking at. We used a little more out of the 2023 crop. They also adjusted down the food, seed, and other category as, you know, corn sweetener demand is lightened a little bit there. But the big change for 2024 was they increased the export number by 70 million bushels. So we're staring at not only a record export year, but you know, that 70 million basically pushed 2024, which was basically in a tie with 2020 as far as record exports. It pushed us to, you know, number one by far. Put it all together, what that meant was that total usage has gone up. We're looking at a record 15.35 billion bushels of corn being utilized here for the 2024 marketing year. So that was really great, and it helped lower the ending stocks for 2024-25 down to 1.3 billion bushels. So good news, but not good enough to necessarily lift USDA season average price. That remains at $4.30 a bushel. Now, as we look at 2025 column, given the expansive supplies we see coming this fall, USDA was like, well, typically, as we have more crop available, that means we see more crop utilized, and they're showing that across the board. They added 250 million to feed and residual. Now, some of that is probably increased feed, but some of that is also probably increased harvest loss, given the massive size of the crop we're looking at here. They added 100 million bushels to the ethanol number, so they continue to see biofuel usage continuing to grow as we look out there. And they added, in this case, 200 million bushels to what they were projecting for exports. So they're saying we set a record this marketing year, we're going to set another record next year, given the size of the crop that we've got right now. And I think a lot of that is based upon, as we look at all the tariff discussion over this past year, one of the things that was feared but did not happen is that we would see other countries target U.S. ag markets for tariffs of their own. Most did not, and that has allowed the export pace for corn to set a record this year and hopefully set another record as we're looking forward for next year. But even when I add up all of that, you know, growth in demand as we look there, we're looking at usage getting up to nearly 16 billion bushels, but not quite. And that what that means is ending stocks are going to build, in this case, by an order of nearly 800 million bushels. And we're looking at the possibility of 2025, 26 ending stocks being north of 2 billion bushels. That, of course, means prices will likely be lower. USDA lowered their season average price estimate by 30 cents down to $3.90 a bushel. Now, the area that came into corn had to come from somewhere. Where it came from was soybeans. And so as we look at the soybean table, this is where we see a more mixed pattern, if you will. We saw planted area go down by 2.5 million, down to 80.9 million acres of planted to soybeans this year. The yield did go up again. The crops do look really good as we look out there. In fact, they ended up raising the estimate up by 1.1 bushels to a projected total of 53.6 bushels per acre. That would be a record yield for soybeans. But when you put those two together, the acreage loss was bigger than the yield gain. And so actually expected production fell by 42 million bushels. So we're now down to 4.29 billion bushels for soybeans. That gave the market, if you will, breathing room now. Because as we look down in the gray box and the usage categories, well, we've been north of 4.3 for this year and will likely remain there as we look forward into the 2025 marketing year. Now, what adjustments did USDA make on the demand side? Well, for 2024, they ended up raising the crush demand up about another 10 million bushels here. They also added 10 million to the export line. So we saw that total usage increase by 20 million bushels compared to last month. That was a positive situation here, and it helped lower 2024 ending stocks to 330 million bushels, so down 20 million there. Then move prices. USDA maintained that $10 price line as we're looking for the average price for beans harvested last fall. Now for 2025, we did see USDA adjust down exports 40 million bushels based upon the continuing, let's call it trade troubles, as we continue to work on trying to find a deal with China, China being the major market for US soybeans. We also saw them downgrade seed and residual by 3 million bushels, again, based upon the lower plantings we saw this year. When you put it all together, 2025 ending stocks actually got lowered by 20 million bushels as well. And so what we're seeing there is ending stocks falling below 300 million bushels. That's a positive sign for the soybean market. But it wasn't enough for USDA to move their season average price estimate for 2025. It remains at $10.10. Now, in terms of looking at the yields we're seeing across the country, not only are we seeing a national record corn yield, but 11 states, including the three I states, the three big states that you need to pay attention to for the corn market, all setting records. Iowa at 222, Illinois at 221, Indiana at 205. Now, in looking forward here, in September, USDA will start to incorporate not only farmer survey estimates of yield, but they'll actually start to bring in that objective yield where they go out into the fields and examine there. And so we'll start to see, do we see this be the high water mark for yield? And do things like, you know, the tar spot and the southern rust that we see out there start to nibble away at these record projected yields. But as you look across the board right now, it does look like a very strong crop for the corn market. Soybeans, very similar in terms of, again, yields are expected to be strong. There just aren't as many acres as we first expected there. Nationwide, 53.6 is the record yield being projected here, but we're seeing a record again. Iowa, Illinois, and Indiana all coming in at records as well. So plenty of crop to work with domestically. And when we look at the world total, the big increase here in U.S. and corn leads to a big increase when we're looking at overall world corn supply. So we're definitely looking at record corn production there. The thing that I was most interested in here is I continue to see growth, especially as we're looking at Ukraine for this year. That will be interesting in terms of the export markets there, because one of the big growth markets for us this past year had been the European Union, which had been buying from Ukraine, had to sort of shift away from them this past year because they had a smaller crop. Now they're going to have a bigger one again. I expect the European Union to shift back towards purchasing more from Ukraine. When you're looking at soybeans, the downgrade in our production here was the big move overall. But we're still looking at, for 2025-26, the biggest soybean crop the world has ever seen. Yeah. And looking at those exports, one of the things I definitely watch at this time of year are advanced sales. What are we doing so far to sell the crop we're growing out in the fields right now? In case of soybeans, those advanced sales are the lowest I've ever seen. At this stage of the game, typically we'll have sold somewhere around 450 to 500 million bushels in the international marketplace. As it stands right now, we're down around 130 million bushels. So we're well below average. And like I say, the slowest pace, at least during my 15, 16 years doing this job. On the other hand, when I'm looking at the corn market, it has definitely perked up over the past 2-3 weeks. In fact, I expect to see this jump again. As you can see here, we're running above our 5-year average, not quite at a record level for advanced sales, but a very strong number, sort of supporting that move that USDA is showing that, hey, if we see these advanced sales really jumping and we continue to see strong old crop sales as well, that does bode well for exports here because we make the vast majority of those sales basically throughout harvest time into the early winter time. But when it comes right down to it, what the markets reacted to today was just the sheer size of the corn crop coming at us. When you're looking at prices, they did retract fairly significantly for corn, but it basically put the futures market in line with where USDA is at now as they're looking at their prices as well. Again, USDA downgraded to 390 for that season average price for the 2025 corn crop. Futures market right now is 398 for that same crop. Now, futures market does show still some hope as we look out for the 2026 crop. As you can see, that season average price estimate right now is holding up there around 440. So the market is saying, yep, we recognize it's a gigantic crop this year, but we're also seeing record usage, and that hopefully means for better times ahead. It just may take us a year or two to get there. When we're looking at soybeans, it was a positive day today in the marketplace, and that helped bring, if you will, the futures market back closer to where USDA is at. USDA has held that 2025 crop at $10.10 a bushel. And the futures market is coming in just a bit shy of that, just a little bit over 10 bucks. As we look towards 2026, though, again, we see some improvement, not as much as we see on the corn side, but you do see that season average price coming in at around 10 and a quarter as we look deeper out there again. So the challenges we've been facing is that we've been able to overproduce for what has been really good demand for both the corn and soybean crops. So it looks like we're going to continue to do that as we finish out this growing season. What that has done is that has definitely bought prices below break even, and in this case, for both crops now. Corn has been on a downward slide, and it's definitely pushed through where our production cost estimates were earlier this year. And so both crops are struggling to try to, if you will, generate enough usage to try to pull us back towards break even. And in fact, the futures market says it may be that we'll have to wait for the 2026-27 crop before we can get back to those levels. But what it also translates into is a place that we've been before. You think back almost a decade ago, back in 2016, 17, 18, even 19, we were seeing prices that were below our production cost for quite a period of time there, where we had to control our cost, manage our margins to deal with the downturn in the agricultural economy, which is something we're facing again here as we, you know, go through the growing season here in 2025. So we have been through a situation like this before. It's difficult, but we also know the steps we need to take in order to, if you will, see the sunlight on the other side. Well, with that, we'll stop sharing here. Again, my name is Chad Hart, Extension Economist at Iowa State University, and hopefully that gives you at least a brief snapshot of all the action that happened with USDA's August reports. With that, we try to produce a video like this about once a month, basically following up on USDA's reports. Hope you find them useful, and hope you enjoy the rest of your day as we move through that.